Okay, so if you've written your MLA essay and you want to make sure all the formatting's right, that's what we're going to show you how to do right now. And the first thing that we're going to check is the margins. So all the way around it should be an inch. To left click over the edges of the white area on the ruler. So if I left click here, you see the one pop up. If I do the same on the vertical ruler, you'll see the one pop up. If you want to check them all for the entire document, just go to File and then Page Setup. And here you'll see that you have 1-inch margins. I'm assuming your paper size is set right. It should be 8.5 by 11. And then just click OK here. For the header of the paper, not just the heading up here, but the actual functional header of the paper, left click once at the top of the paper, and it will get you above the content up into here. And then this text that I have is right aligned here. It's not left aligned. So if I down key, you'll see it'll shift over to the right. That's what's happening here. You would type your name. And then when you insert this number, this is a dynamic number and it needs to change with each page. So you would go to insert, header and page number, and then select page number. When you look at these, you want to do the one that starts with the one and then a two in the upper right hand corner. The one on the right actually looks like it may be similar, but it skips the first page. But in this case, we don't have a title page, so you're going to want to start the page numbering on the first page. So select the one in the upper left-hand corner. And if you look at the page number right now, it has a gray background, and that's telling you that it's dynamic, and Google Docs is thinking about that number and realizes it needs to put a one there. So if I scroll down to page two, going to see that it figured out that it should be page two. So you don't have to manually type these in. You should have Google Docs do it for you. That way, if you add or subtract pages, they'll still be right. If we left click back into the body of the text, you need to have this specific header in this order. So first have your name and then your professor's name, then the name of your subject and today's date. So after the header that you have typed here, come down to the title, make sure this is center aligned. So when I go up to the toolbar here, you'll see if I hover over this option, it's center aligned. I didn't type this in and hit space or tab several times to get it here. I just typed it in over at the left-hand side and then center aligned it. And now you're ready to come down to the body of your text. So we're going to select, pull this all the way down to the bottom. And in this case, I had to select it holding the left mouse key down, and then I had to use a scroll key on the mouse. You can also just hit the down arrow on your keyboard and then go up to format, line spacing, and the entire paper needs to be double spaced. So that's checked right now. And the important thing to notice here is that, so after this word, there is no enter key pressed. And I certainly didn't press it twice to get to the double spacing. I just typed this word, I hit the space bar, and then I kept typing the next word. And the spacing is just governed by you telling it to be double spaced. You're not hitting enter twice. You don't hit enter until you want an entirely new line, and that would start a new paragraph. Now you can also see that each new paragraph is indented. So the first line, if you go up to the ruler, is indented a half an inch. Select the text that you want. We're just going to make this quicker here and select these three paragraphs. And you go to format and alignment, and just make sure that when you look at your indentation options, the first line is a half an inch. That's going to apply until you get down to your works cited page. And at the point that we get down there, I'll show you how to do a hanging indent. And the next thing that you want to do, so we still have these three paragraphs highlighted, for all of the body of your text, make sure that you're left aligned. You don't want to be justified. So if you look at the right-hand side of this text, if it was justified, so we'll use this option on the right, everything would be smooth. But in order to do that, it changes the spaces in between the words to get everything even. And that's not what you're supposed to be doing. So keep it on left aligned, even though it might not look quite as good to the eye. You just want it to stay at the natural spacing like that. And as far as the font, you want to have everything selected for this. So let's use the shortcut key. Let's hold down Control and hit A. And keep everything in 12-point font and use the Times New Roman. MLA just specifies that it should be a readable text, but Times New Roman is your most common, so just be safe and keep it at that. Okay, now we'll scroll down to the Works Cited page. And a couple of things to take note of here before we get too far into it is that, for one, your header is still here, so it's still your name and the page number. And you should still have your 1-inch margins all the way around. And if you only have one work cited, make sure you take the S off of the title here. Otherwise, it's okay. Each one of these citations should be in alphabetical order by the author's last name. Now, when you come to the title, make sure that that's center aligned, and then select the rest of the content. This should all be double spaced still, but you'll notice that there's a different type of indentation here. So the first line is flush with the 1-inch left-hand margin, but the second and the third line, if there is, so all the subsequent lines in each entry have what's called a hanging indent. And that's a half inch from the left margin into here. So it's 1.5 inches. And you get to this hanging indent by going to Format, Align an Indent, and then come down to the bottom where it says Indentation Options. If you select that, I've already done it here. It's a hanging indent and it should be a half inch. And when you click Apply, there you go. So your hanging indent is done. So your report now has the basic formatting that you need for an MLA essay. And now you might like watching the video that's kind of a full tutorial with Google Docs. So you can just sit back, watch it. It's 25 minutes long. And at the end of that, you should have a pretty solid understanding of how to use Google Docs. If you like this video and you find it helpful, please subscribe in the lower right-hand corner. And you can click that little notification bell if you want to see these videos as they're made available. Thanks.